guys, Dagan from PMTV UK here at the Winter NAMM Show 2019 with the man of the hour. He pretty much runs NAMM now. Mr. Jared James Nichols, how's it going, sir?
You know, I walked into NAMM and they were like, hey man, we just need a new board member. So, you know, I was elected.
Yeah.
So now I'm running it.
The president
it's crazy.
Of the NAMM pulled out his sword and knight you.
The NAMM, yeah, that's it. Hey man, PMT, so glad, man. Thanks for coming and doing this.
I never would have thought this would have happened years ago when I did that rig run down with you and supporting the UFO.
Yeah. That was so cool.
So good, man. And now you're sat here with your new signature Epiphone, and downstairs you've got your new signature Black Star amp.
Yeah.
And your face is all over the shop.
It's so funny, man. In the past 48 hours, I've it's like a blur, right? Like last night, I'm on stage, Billy Gibbons, Peter Frampton, Nancy Wilson, Kenny Arnold, like. It's been crazy, dude.
Yeah.
And I mean that in like the coolest way. You know what I mean?
Well, it's very deserving because you work your ass off. You two at the UK, which is obviously a tiny little island miles away from here. About three times in a year you were there?
Yeah, I love the UK. I love playing in the UK, man. And the UK, it's so sick. It's funny. When I used to go there, I was like, everyone's like, oh, you're driving on the other side. You know, everything was weird. Dude, the UK is awesome. It's so much fun to play there. Mm-hmm. And it's always a treat to go.
You're far too kind, man. But anyways, let's get to... not the elephant in the room anymore, but everyone knew it was coming. When it finally landed, it blew everyone away.
Yeah,
the Epiphone Old Glory, man.
This is it. This is the prototype they sent me. And there's one in the other room. But man, I'm super proud of this. It's basically, it's modeled after my Gibson that I like modded myself. And
what was the story of that again? Didn't your missus get you on? Get you?
Yeah,
as
she's sitting over there. Yeah. So check this out.
So she started all this.
She did. It's her fault. I always say, it's your guitar, by the way. You know, it's your thing. So, yeah, I got that guitar. We were on tour, actually, with Lynyrd Skynyrd, years ago, and I saw the guitar. It was on Reverb before Reverb was, a thing.
Yeah.
Like, I used to go and type in, single pickup Les Paul, single pickup. I was trying to find one, right? And I found this one a guy custom ordered in, Delaware.
Right.
And I found the listing, and the listing straight up, it literally said, single pickup Black Les Paul custom. And he goes, I ordered this guitar from the custom shop, and it's nothing what I wanted. Like, he said that.
Nothing what you wanted?
He goes, yeah. And he goes, I'm selling this to try and get another one, right? And I remember, I was like, a custom order, custom shop. I was like, is this a real ad? And I said to her, I said, look at this guitar. And I said, let's put this on the credit card. It was $2,000.
Wow.
And I was like, I got to see this thing, you know?
Yeah.
And it had a return and all that. Mm-hmm. And I got the guitar and I was blown away. It was new. And that's the Old Glory, right?
Yeah.
But the thing about it was it had a soap bar on it and it had a tune-o-matic and a bunch of different stuff. And I took it and I started modding it.
Yeah.
I put a dog ear on it. And then I even took off the tune-o-matic and I made it a rap tail and did all this crazy stuff. Long story short, I was so influenced by that guitar. I was captivated by it, you know? And it's funny. Then... I didn't even think it was a thing, but everyone was like, oh, yeah, you're that one pickup guy, or you're the guy that doesn't use the pick.
Yeah.
And it, started becoming, what's the word, a gimmick. Yeah, it was, gimmicky. And then I was wait a minute, I didn't mean to do any of this, you know?
Yeah, it's the way I roll.
Yeah, it's just the way I roll, and I'm super proud of this. And the thing I think about it that people are going to dig is when you plug it in, you play it, you sound like you, you know? It's everyone's going to sound different on it. And the beauty is in the simplicity because, you know, it's got a USA Seymour Duncan.
Very nice.
Yes. Rap tail, lightning bar tail piece. We got volume tone. You got your, that's where you plug in, right? No. It's got jumbo frets. It's got a fat neck. So it's
the neck is lovely.
It's comparable to maybe a 58, 58 style, if that works. It's got Grovers. If you can see that on the back, it's got the Grovers and a little Stinger headstock.
The Stinger is so cool, man.
The thing that I want people to know about this, too, is with the Epiphone stuff, it's so good, man.
You've been flying the flag for Epiphone for a long time.
What I'm really proud about this guitar is a lot of people think Epiphone and they think of something that's a lesser product. It really isn't. This has jumbo frets. It has an ebony board, a big neck, Grovers, a Duncan. Everything about this guitar, it's just a perfect platform, I think, for a lot of players to, you know, dig in. And if you don't like the plate, take it off. I don't care.
Is there actually studs underneath? Is there studs underneath?
No, I wish there were.
Just in case.
It's so funny, man.
No, I like how it says Blues Power as well. That's kind of been your go-to for years, isn't it?
It was, the original plate said custom made, right? Mm-hmm. And I remember Richard at Epiphone, they're like, oh, send us your specs, you know? And it's I did it in 2 minutes. I was I thought about the guitar. It's that dream every kid has. Mm-hmm. Make your specs of your dream guitar. And literally, I sent him my specs. Mm-hmm. And he goes, what about instead of the custom-made plate, we put Blues Power on it?
Oh,
I was
dude,
that'd
so
be
cool.
Sick, you know? So we did that. And yeah, it's simple, man. It's a simple guitar, but I just love it. I love the way it plays. Turned
it's
out
loud,
great.
Like acoustically, it's loud.
It's loud.
I had 2 seconds playing it before, and it certainly rings, man.
Yeah,
great.
You hear that? Can you hear that? I'm just kidding. Yeah, no, it's great. And I can't wait to get these over to the UK and, you know, have people try them out and
amazing.
Try,
well,
see
I'm
for themselves.
Definitely, as you can probably guess, going to get one.
Of course.
Without a shadow of a doubt.
I'm going to hook that up, man. Absolutely.
I really hope I do, because it's so deserving, and it's such an iconic guitar. Thank now you. Associated with. Actually, do you still keep in contact with the guy who you bought it off? Or do you know who it is?
No.
Dragon's watching like NAMM footage going like...
The best part is...
Wait.
Yeah, hey, that was my guitar I custom ordered. The best part is like Matt from Gibson Custom, right? Mm-hmm. When he saw the guitar, he's like, well, if you give me the serial number, I can run it, you know? And he was able to find out everything. He's like, yeah, this guy custom ordered this guitar. And it just is so funny to me because even when I bought it, I was taking a chance. So like, it's like as guitar players, we're always searching for like the next best thing, right? And I remember I saw that guitar and I was like, something about it just was like black custom and like just the simplicity. And then, I don't know, man. It's just funny how it all evolved, you know? But here we are talking about it.
I know, it's been a crazy couple of years for you. And I guess it's going to get crazier and crazier as well because it's all brand new. You've got a tour of this. You've got to take it on the road. You've got to show everyone. You've got to...
Yeah.
It's saying that. This is final prototype. When's it due out?
April.
April?
Yeah, April. They said that it'll be in stores in April. So I'm really excited.
Is it a limited run?
It is a limited run.
Okay.
Yeah, it is a limited run. So I don't know how many guitars they're making or how many are going to the UK at this point or anything. Mm-hmm. But man, I hope that they're in the PMTs and we got to make it happen.
Thank you so much, dude. Well, it's a pleasure as always.
Always, man.
Thank you so much. Killer guitar. Very deserving.
Thank you, brother.
And I'll see you around the next couple of days.
Let's have some beers, you know what I mean?
Definitely, without a doubt. Cheers, dude. Thanks.